Hey everyone, Justin Smith here, Scouting and Recruiting Analyst for Touchdown Alabama. Thank you guys so much for joining me today on our YouTube page. Hit that like button, hit that subscribe button. Subscribers, hit that notification bell. Be notified when we drop content on our YouTube page. Today, I'm here to continue our Spring Preview Spotlight series where we break down players who could make a huge splash for the Crimson Tide this spring, guys who could play significant roles for the Tide on next season as well. And today I'm going to take a look at the Tide's true freshman and early enrollee out of Etna Carr High School in New Orleans, Louisiana. And I'm talking about Aaron Anderson, a former five-star recruit who's one of the top wide receivers in the 2022 recruiting class, listed at 5'9" and weighing 185 pounds. I remember when I first got an opportunity to see him in person, which was at the Under Armour game and practices during the month of January. And when I first saw him, just looking at his frame, he looks sort of like a running back in terms of that 5'9", 185 pound frame. Does not have great length, but he definitely makes up for it with a fantastic vertical. This is a wide receiver who can climb the ladder and make some contested catches in the air, high point the football down the field. Great speed, has a PR of 10.77 and the 100 meter dash. So you know this is a guy with some breakaway speed, and that speed translates over to the football field as you guys are seeing some of his film. When I saw him at the Under Armour practices, he really stood out. I thought he was one of the top wide receivers throughout the week, had a pretty good game as well. Almost caught a touchdown, pretty much caught a touchdown, but the referee did not call it a touchdown. But it was debatably a touchdown, but it did not count. But he did have a pretty good performance throughout the week, like I said. And the thing that really impressed me was his route running. This is a guy who runs controlled routes, tight routes, fantastic routes, routes that can put defenders in blenders at times, as he had guys spinning around trying to see where he was when he ran some routes at the Under Armour practices against some of the top defensive backs in the 2022 recruiting cycle. That speed translates over to his route running as well. So I think he's a guy who could possibly push to get early playing time next season. And I think this spring, I think Alabama fans may get introduced to him during the spring game, during a day, if he has a great spring. As far as getting on the field, it may be a bit difficult, although it is an unproven wideout room for the Crimson Tide. They are returning a lot of slot wide receivers. Just taking a look at Christian Leary, JoJo Earl, who is expected, I would believe, by most people to be the starting slot wide receiver for the Crimson Tide next season because he earned so much playing time as a freshman. He also returned Tyree Jones-Bell, another veteran wide receiver. So Aaron Anderson is going to face some stiff competition to get on the field next season. But if he has a great spring, I think he's going to get closer to that being a possibility for him. So I definitely think he's a guy to watch out for. I think he has all the tools to push to possibly get on the field, and I think he can have a good spring. And I think it is great that he's already on campus. So he's definitely a guy I would keep my eyes out for. A talented athlete, has the speed, great route running ability, can go up and make some contested catches in the air. Very elusive with the football in his hands, has breakaway speed, great top end speed, can pull away from defenders in the open field. So I think Alabama fans should definitely be excited about the former five-star wide receiver out of Etna Carr High School in New Orleans, Louisiana. As always, I am Justin Smith, the scouting and recruiting analyst for Touchdown Alabama Magazine. Don't forget to like, subscribe, hit the notification bell, be notified when we drop content on our YouTube page.